Hello, welcome to the stream. I know many of you know the exact feeling. You know exactly the feeling. Well, I got the mod working. Thank you, Red Jackal. Yeah, there were some steps that I hadn't done. But this is the Vine Sauce mod by Cheesy Draws. And, it looks like it's gonna be some minor upgrades. I consider them upgrades. But yeah, it seems really cool. I'm excited. So welcome to the stream. If you, if you'd like to participate in Death Roulette, I'll link you to it. I don't know if any of my mods are around. But yeah, we're gonna do some Splunk. And if you want to bet on my death, you can do so right this second. I think at some point a mod will show. Okay, Sphinx. You down for that, Sphinx? You sure it's not a bother? Well, I'm gonna bet on my own victory. Hell yeah. Bet on victory. Where am I going? Today will be all volcano. I need to work on my volcanoes. So. Which means I'm fucked. No, I really want to make volcano viable. So what's different in the Vine Sauce mod? A couple things. I guess I can play as me. My name is Rafi now, everybody. If it has a new texture, it probably has a new journal entry or custom death. Okay, cool. Thank you again, Cheesy, for making this. I'll have to check this out. I might not stop for every journal entry. I'm probably just gonna try to enjoy the game. And, like, see where, you know. Where I can. Well, apparently you can't edit some things easily. So, I'm Rafi, but eventually I'll be Vinny, maybe. Who knows? But yeah, Death Roulette. Remember, you can check out that link. Vinny, did you see the Bruce Willis compilation vid from Ralph the Movie Maker? I did, he broke it down for me. It was good. I'll take you anytime, punk! Was it number one, Jeff? No, it was number six. One of those shitty Bruce Willis movies was, like, number six on Netflix. Crazy. The snakes begin to laugh. This is our currently once a week Spelunky, but there may come a time where I do this more often. When I get motivated enough to, like, get the true ending, or second true ending, I may, like, play a little bit more often than I am now. But for now, we'll do once a week. And, you know, just try to keep my skills up. We'll do some Death Roulette, have some fun. And then when I'm really feeling, like, serious, then you'll know. So this is good practice for me, because I'm going to be going all volcano. But, yeah, if you wanna bet, the bets will close as soon as I enter that door. You ready? Bet's closing... now. Cool. Thank you, Sphinx, by the way, I appreciate it, and any of my other mods that end up helping with it. I hope you're all doing okay. Today's been pretty good. New AVGM was good, I enjoyed that video. I enjoyed his Pink Floyd reference in the video. I do the same shit. It was, yeah, it was good, I liked it. It was like Action 52, but with some good games. Action 69. It was nice to see, like, a classic, like, series of just shitty games. I very much enjoyed that video. Violence fight. but I have some news. Vinny, he made a you joke. I'm not gonna lie, I may have texted James. This is gonna come across like a brag, and it is. Because I'm a fan, I like James a lot, but I said, nice Pink Floyd reference. I'm a fan. Good video, good Pink Floyd reference. There you go, there's my brag for the day. I haven't bothered the dude in years. As soon as he makes a Pink Floyd reference, I'm like, hey man, good video. That was my accomplishment in life today, and I was very proud of myself. Okay, my news. I have actual news. The news is Zelda 2 Randomizer has been updated as of 2 days ago. And it's a good update too, chat. 50% encounter rate. I'll tell you all the features because it's incredible. It's absolutely, like, incredible. Community palace levels. What I mean by that is, like, there are rooms that are now completely different that were designed by the community. There's tons of balance updates. There's a fucking option, chat, to, hang on, I want to get this thing open because it's amazing. There's an option for the overworld that allows you to hide less important locations. There's one continent connections, normal. You can have, all water is walkable with boots. Continent biome, vanilla-like, vanilla shuffled, islands, canyon, caldera, mountains, random, no vanilla, random with vanilla. There's so many options for map generation now. There's even restrict connection cave shuffle. When selected, caves will be placed in a more logical manner. That's amazing. There's new sprites for Link. Like I said, there's a palace style. You can do community rooms. There's different drop rates that you can fuck around with. Removed items are no longer replaced with a pee bag. Implemented a level cap. Option for town signs to give you hints. This is an incredible update. This is huge. And it's like 3 days after I did my randomizer run for the year. So I'm considering at some point, maybe, possibly, damn it, doing another run. It's such a big update, I only scratch the surface in the stuff I've told you. Now, for me, a Zelda 2 nerd, I'm excited. For you, you might think, okay, that's cool, but the randomizer can get real crusty. This seems like runs can be way more customizable. I wish it was released before Thanksgiving, but since it wasn't, that just means that there's more... another Zelda 2 run at some point. And I think it would be a little less frustrating, too, if I set the right options. But, I mean, who knows? You could probably also keep full frustration mode if you want. Shame there's no update for remaster, but I assume there would be a huge undertaking. Oh, Redux? Someone in chat emailed me and said that they tried it and it worked with Redux. So, but like some of the seeds crash. So my worry is that I would do a Redux Zelda 2 seed and I would get to like fucking 80% through the game and it would crash and not work. That's my fear. Oh yeah, the bombs look cool. I like the vine whip. The vine ropes are cool. So there was a Spelunky 1 Vine Sauce mod, and this is definitely an homage in some ways. Like those the gems are shrooms. That's familiar. But I like this. This is really good. Sen. Oh yeah, 3D Sen. There's the 3D emulator. The lizards look more like Desert Pea. Okay, I have to look at those a little more closely. But yeah, there's a I've done it. I've done a stream of it, but there's basically, yeah, 3D. NES. And it looks great. And it can be played in VR. I considered doing my Zelda 2 run in it, but I would be distracted. But I'm gonna see. Maybe if I do another run, I'll do it in... Nice pizza. I'll do it in 3D. Ugh. That was scary. But we're good. We are good. Vinny, you should try getting the secret final area once at least. There's an achievement for getting there. Yeah, so I've heard. I'm not sure I can even get there yet. So, my plan is not to attempt to get there. I want to get that second ending. And if I feel like it's not happening, then I'm just going to go for the regular ending. Very poorly. Vinny, I saw V-Dub in a bar fight in New Jersey today. I would not be surprised. Vinny, it said 3D Sen works with Zelda 2. I think it would. I think it would work with Randomizer. Yeah. It should. There's no reason why it wouldn't. There he is. There's the pet. That's good. Ah. 3D Sen works with Zelda Redux. Cool. Awesome. Oof. Well, we're not getting that pizza. There's a manslave we can probably use if I have enough time. Wasting a lot of bombs. Not wasting, utilizing, let's just say. Utilizing. It's just there's a lot to, you know, you usually need a lot of bombs. But yeah, Kapala has been obtained. This is good. This is exactly what I need for Vlad. So, let's see if I can live. A lot depends on if there's a fuckload of lava. Bombs? Would you sacrifice your mods to kill Kali? No. to pee. Why would I kill Kali? Oh, to appease Kali. Did I read that wrong? I might have read that wrong. That's that, yeah, no, why that, no. Nope. However, for a Travis Scott burger, also no. Yeah, I have to be careful down here because I don't have any rope. Foo Fighters! Still no damn rope. Can't get up there. Oh, okay. Spike ball, 32,000 coins paid to 3 players. Give me some rope, I'm coming loose. Alright, place your bets, everybody. You ready? Also going volcano. I'm just going volcano, like, the whole night. Listen, if I have to adapt to death roulette, I may as well use it for practice. I wonder if I had rope, would I still have been pulped? I might still have been pulped, chat. So I watched, what Deep Space Nine episode am I on, for anyone who watches that show? I'm on, Odo's Slime Baby. I know it sounds weird, but it's a good episode. And, then I watched the one after that, where Sisko is basically on a rampage to catch someone who has done crimes. It's a long story, but it's a good episode. A really good episode. The Sisko. Love that show so much. Really enjoying my second watch through of it of all time. Vinny, watching TNG at your recommendation and the robot had sex with the blonde. What the fuck? Well, that's one way to put it. Okay, we can close the bets. Thank you. Do you like Star Trek Enterprise? Yeah, it's okay. It started pretty bad, got better, and then they canceled it just as it got good. But, anyway, yeah, I just wanted to do a status report. And yes, Data is fully functional. That would have been a cool episode if they just like some like creepy sex pervert wanted to like make copies of Data, like for the pleasure of others. Maybe Quark wants to like run a sex enterprise. Enterprise. Okay. Man, What? Ah! I've made a terrible mistake. I just wanted to get the key. I like the little scoots, it's a nice touch. Look at me panicking and losing 3 health. The shopkeeper has done nothing to me. Of my own accord, I just thought it would be really cool to lose 3 health. Where's the key thing? It's nowhere in sight. Excellent. Do I? Wait, does this count as me having killed the shopkeeper? Yes. Awesome. He was aggroed, so yes. So there's no forgiveness here, no, is what you're saying. There is still? You sure about that? You can still be forgiven, it just takes longer. Take all this nice equipment. Indeed I will. There's a cape up there. I missed it. I didn't see it. Oh, good for me. Oh, you're right. Yeah. Why have the pets not been replaced with the other streamers, says a chat member. Oh, okay. Have you considered that maybe this is just a hobby? For someone? And like, you know, this isn't a full Vinesauce mod, it's like a little Vinesauce mod. A lot of work. Oh yeah, it's more desert-like. I see it. That's good. My mobility's not bad for where I'm at right now. I have to deal with fucking angry shopkeepers, but oh well. It's fine, right? Homeboy almost killed me. Pets should each be a third of Germa's dump truck ass. Fuck! I luckily have enough bombs where I can do something like that. Gonna need a key. I really don't like the volcano. There was a time where I thought the volcano was easier than the jungle. I don't know what I was thinking. It is. I don't find it easier. I mean, granted, this is a me problem. I just have a hard time with it. Maybe it's like Spelunky 1. Muscle memory for the jungle? I don't know. Vinny, don't shoot the robots, I know. Sadly, we can't rescue the pup. Confident about rescuing that particular dog. It's good stuff. There's paste in there, chat. I figured it would be worth the bomb call. Oh, good fucking thing I did that. Otherwise, that fire would have got me. But it's worth the bomb cost, considering there's another pack over there. See, now I'm a little bit too excited to use bombs. I'm using them a little too much. Be more careful about that. Bombs. Morshu could probably be the shopkeeper. In Spelunky, if you think about it. It works. Let me see if I can pulp the shopkeeper. Hang on. Alright, it's a little pulpage. I forgot I have sticky bombs now. I just want pet to go in. Nice. Oh, piss off, shopkeeper. Enjoy your lava. God, this is why I don't like volcano. Ah! How do you know? How you guys doing on lava? You need lava? I don't know what that noise is, but I like it. Alright, you can open the bets. Damn, that was a good one. That started real great. Accidental shopkeeper death aside, that was a good start. Had tons of bombs. Had some good mobility, but I just fucking always have to deal with the damn lava drip underneath that machinery. I hate it. Where's the pet? No pet. All right, fine. Your bombs can make the passage to Vlad safe. I know. I think it's about 8 bombs, is it? You had 30 bombs. Yeah, I know. I figured maybe if I just took my time, I could use a couple to get rid of the lava and then go down. But I was a little impatient. And then also the thing fell on me. So. But that's life, Denny. Please don't destroy the ghost jar. Please don't destroy the ghost jar. Yeah. Ooh, oh. Turkeys really aren't worth much, but something. Bombs over there, I definitely want those.
Rats!
I said France. We come from France. I'm gonna get that paste. Just wanna make sure I sacrifice a little bit. I'm not really sure how much more sacrificing we're gonna do here. Yeah. Buy out the damn store. Okay. Alright. Well, if we come across another fucking mole! If we come across another altar. It'll be really easy. Oh, there's another one. Okay, hang on a minute. I just need something, anything really. A mole would help. Wouldn't be enough, but I think a mole. A mole and one other thing. So we'll just go back up there and get the mole. 5 vine rope. Not going down there. Ah, died. You can sacrifice the idol. Yeah, it turns into like a monkey. Fucking snakes. Oh. I really need that Kapala. Drastic measures, chat. If I need to, I will burn through my rope. We need to live. Okay, how many more ropes do I have? 1. But we have at least a minute left here. A minute and 20. Now we harvest the blood of the enemies. Hear the lamentations. Hear the lamentations of the lizards. I didn't get any of that blood, but that's alright. Try to collect some blood. Why do you sacrifice dogs? Says chat member. It's spelunky. It's a lot to explain. It's spelunky. But you sacrifice to build favor with Kali, who will give you good items and Kapala, which will allow you to absorb blood for life. So, very worth it, even if it is a little barbaric. Even if it is a little Hanna-Barbera, it's worth it. Do I waste my last rope getting that? I think yes. Also, this snake's now red to reflect the snakes will begin to laugh. I just noticed that. I got some health. I am very appreciative of the iframes on those bombs. So that they don't explode immediately. Can't bleed him, but I will take care of this. Alright. Problem solved. I have no rope. I have to be really careful now. I could easily get stuck in a moment that you can't get out of.
You've got to get yourself together.
Remember when U2 put themselves on everyone's iPhones or iPods or whatever the fuck that was? And no one wanted it? It's a shame. What's a shame is that U2 actually has a couple good songs. A couple good albums entirely. And it's just so easy to make fun of them because of very valid reasons. But they, you know, they had to resort to like putting their songs on people's phones without their consent. It's almost like what Amazon's doing with their thing. They're doing a Amazon spy thing? Sidewalk that you have to disable. Where they collect like information from you and you have to opt out of it. It should be you have to opt in it, but they, you know. They're not letting you do that. Steal from the shop. So you're new to the Spelunky streams, huh? That's okay. I understand. I was new to Spelunky once, too. So here's why stealing would be bad. I'll explain, actually, for any of the newcomers. Stealing, I usually like to do, but then the shopkeepers wait at the end of every level. And in a run like this, where I've already made it this far without stealing, I would prefer not to make the game harder for myself. If there was a jetpack, I certainly would consider it, but I wouldn't steal some of the more basic items that I could buy. Especially if you have enough money. Is this game good, says a chat member. Please at me. Yes. I'm gonna say yes. But I'm gonna say that this game will frustrate you beyond belief if you don't put a lot of time in it. And you don't attempt to learn how to, like, be very careful, but also quick enough not to, like, die. It's a delicate balance. You see how I just do pop 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 pop? I'm loving it. Eat dick. That was my fault entirely, too. That's what I'm talking about. That was an example of how careful you have to be in Spelunky. And that made me very sad. And I hated that. That's okay, the snakes begin to laugh and, you know, when you laugh with the world laughs with you. But when you cry, the world bleeds. Vinny, you got that quote from Old Boy. Did I? That was definitely not the Old Boy quote. What I said made no sense. There was probably, like, way better in Old Boy. Oh, shit. Okay. Oh, wow. Well, Vin just made a huge error. Cat got stuck. The Old Boy quote was, "Father!" Different Old Boy. Way worse version of Old Boy. But you're not wrong, sadly. Old Boy remake is a joint, not a movie. It's just weird to me that Spike Lee would even take that movie. Like, that dude, you know, like, is a real director. Like, what is he doing with Old Boy remake? Must have offered him a lot of money, I guess. I don't know. A Bruce Willis joint. Bruce Willis as Old Boy. He made the new David Byrne concert movie. Who, Spike Lee? Because Jonathan Demme made the Stop Making Sense movie, which is one of my favorite concert things ever made. Yeah, for American Utopia. It was good. I'd recommend people check it out. I didn't see the movie version of it, but I saw it live. And there's some really good songs in there, and some good Talking Heads songs done in a more modern... Well, not even modern, because that would do it a disservice to say that they're modern. In an interesting way. Some are more faithful than others, but all are good. My favorite, I think my favorite Talking Head song that he did was Born Under Punches, but also, you know, Burning Down the House was really good when he did that for American Utopia. So high recommendations. Vinny, my Rimworld colony of 20 ducks and 2 people was raided and destroyed. I'm so sorry. Let's say a prayer for the ducks. Or at the very least, you can... I'll tell you what. If anyone wants to help this poor chat member... Alright? Just... I want you to close your eyes for 2 seconds and picture... Picture the ducks in your mind's eye. Okay, you're done. That's it. That's all you have to do. I thought about it. Like, what's something that everyone can do and not really protest? You know what I mean? Like, I protest. I am not a merry man. Anakin! Good. Jesus. So, I have a bit of a problem. I have, like, a lot of problems, right? But you know, here's the one. As we all do. Here's the one I'm going to talk to you about, chat. I have a bit of a problem. Here's the problem. My autoplay on YouTube, when I'm just letting it go, and I don't want to think about what to watch, like, say I'm cleaning or cooking or whatever, my autoplay is usually okay. It's not bad. It's not great. It's not bad. But... lately... actually, it's been doing this for a long time, but it always seems to go back to Red Letter Media reviewing some Star Wars movie. On a half in the bag or a plinket. It starts with, like, Terminator Dark Fate, and then it ends up with Rogue One or Solo. And even though I've seen them multiple times each, I just watch them. Maybe not, like, actively. I might not watch them, like, paying attention to the, you know, every detail, every moment, but... if they're on, yeah, I just watch them. But now, like, Carl Pilkington has been showing up a lot. And, like, there's one that I really like where it's Steve versus Carl. And it's just, like, insults from Carl about Steve's appearance. And then insults about Carl's intelligence from Steve. And it's, like, a 2.5 hour long compilation. And it just keeps popping up. And I listen to it. Skull, come off. I guess I could just do this, right? It's fine. I just do that. Eyes that, pop out of the head. Steve. Exactly, that's the exact moment I'm talking about. What was Carl referencing when he was talking about eyes popping out of people's heads? What was the, he was talking about something. Like, maybe a record? He was talking about, like, a monkey, like a type of monkey. Or something, yeah. I'm not having a go, Steve. You know, you're a good bloke. But, Ooh! Had to get used to it. It was a bit weird. This little twat. Please! Ah! You plan on streaming the Game Awards in 9 days. Not gonna risk it. I thought about it. After getting a copyright strike, I have decided I'm more than likely not going to be streaming the awards. I'm sorry, chat. I already know that my brain would probably catch on fire from secondhand embarrassment from the Game Awards. And maybe, you know, I can deal with that, but then I thought about it further, and I'm like, do I want to risk getting a fucking strike? Because they're going to be playing copyrighted music. And you know, when they reveal games, it's going to be like an indie, like, techno-pop remix. I don't even know what techno-pop means, I'm sorry. Of a song that gets claimed. And I just don't feel comfortable risking it this year, after everything that's happened on Twitch. It's been a tough enough year as is, and I hate the volcano. Holy fuck, do I hate the volcano. I mean, I was really excited to squirm through, you know, Gamers at Home compilation. But honestly, at this point, I don't think I want to do it. Or like, you know, developers talking about how much they enjoy their thing, and then you find out that they worked like 60-hour weeks in a row. It's like, I can already see the whole thing. And Last of Us 2 is gonna win. You know, I can see it. I can see it in my mind's eye. It's gonna be fine. Everyone's gonna love it. I don't think anything particularly amazing is gonna get revealed. But I just don't really, I guess I don't wanna risk it, but also, let's just say maybe it's okay I take a year off. Maybe I don't need to stream it this year, aside from all the DMCA strike implications, which I'd be worried about. Also, this run is fucked already. It's so sick, it's fucked. No, I'm not gonna reset the run. Are you gonna play Subnautica expansion when it's released? When it's fully done, I will play it, yeah. Did you hear about the new Switch update? Yeah. I read before some of the update stuff, but I don't remember what it was. It was a firmware update, but what happened? What did they do in it, in the firmware update? Still no folders. Still no themes. Stability. Switch Online is now at the bottom. That's good. You can send your photos to the computer. Okay. Does it fix Hyrule Warriors frame rates? Honestly, after Super Hydlide yesterday, I don't feel like Age of Calamity's frame rates are even as bad as I thought they were. They're not great, but God, Super Hydlide, it made me appreciate the small things in life. Like an unstable 20 to 30 frames per second. Ah yes, the good life. What's it called? Virtual Hydlide? Right. That game was pretty fun. Also, I have a confession to make, chat. Today, I played Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War Warfare. And I got really good with the M16. I was getting kill streaks left and right. I was number one on my team. I know you don't believe me. That's okay. You don't have to believe me. I was actually really surprised at how well I was doing. I was like seeing Matrix today, chat. I don't know how it happened. But I got play of the game twice. I only played it like an hour. I just played an hour. And yeah, this is not like my usual, like, I don't play them every year. I don't play a lot of them, but for some reason, I was John Matrix, and it felt really good. By the way, John Matrix is the name of Arnold's character in Commando, so that's actually a double reference. Steve. Alright, Carl, don't have a go. Do I go? Yeah, I should probably get some extra money. Shotgun is a nice thing to have. Ah! Christ on bread. Vinny, kill streaks are now score streaks, and they don't reset on death. Yeah, I've noticed that, but I was, like, consistently getting my top one before the matches ran out. Vin, you could scum the game awards if you want to. I am aware of that. I just don't know if I want to suffer through it this year. I just don't know if I want to. Like, copyright reasons, A, and B, I have my own reasons. I just don't think I can handle it. I just don't need to be live for that. Do you remember that one where I just played Smash Brothers throughout the whole thing? Yeah. Maybe I'll just host it and we can chat. I don't know. I'm not even sure I'll even want to be home for that. You know what I mean? Like, will I be available for that? We'll see. I'm not sure. I'm not that bothered about it. I just know that I don't want to risk streaming it on my main channel at the very least. So. Steve. Vinny, you can do commentary and have us watch it ourselves. I am aware, I literally just explained, I don't know if I even care enough to do that. Because it's just gonna end up being one of those awkward game award years. So I don't think I'm interested. I apologize. Yes, chat, please, let me have this. So there's more than one reason, but I just don't care that much. We could join the Great Link. Vinny, we want cringe. Just watch the game awards yourself, then. Oh, man. All right, fine, turkey. This is what has to happen. Vinny, are you ready to watch a grid view of 30 different online gamers at their home setup talking about how tough a year it's been, how the gaming community has persevered by being gamers? I mean, you pretty much just called it. And like, you know, here's the thing. I don't want to make fun of people who are like going through COVID because I lost someone to it. You know what I mean? Like at the beginning of the year, like it's going to be a lot of that. I'm just going to sit there in silence sweating. I don't need that. Like it's not going to be a good year for the haha funnies. Aside from all the other reasons. So, all right, time to get melted. God, I hate this level. And then Last of Us 2 is- I just think Last of Us 2 is gonna win. I just have a feeling it will. This seems like the type of award show where- I'd be happy to be wrong. I mean, I'd give it to Hades or Final Fantasy VII Remake of the games on there, you know? But I have a feeling it's gonna be Last of Us 2, and that's gonna- I have a skeleton key. Oh yeah, I do. That's gonna piss a lot of people off. So, I'm just gonna watch passively and enjoy the show, but I'm not going to- I just- you know. I don't need to be a part of that. Oh, great. Oh. Desperately need rope. What have I done? I don't see this easier than the jungle. I really don't. Desperately need some rope. Rope. Lamp oil. Bombs. Is that Von Horsling up there? No? Oh, that's where the key was, right? Oh, that was a cool waste of a bomb. This place is a wasteland of messages. How one reads such nonsense boggles me. You have to adapt to it. I mean, the thing is, you kind of swim against the tide and like kind of be miserable, or you just swim with it and acknowledge that some forms of communication in this chat room are non-existent. Best you can do. Yes, manslave. You go take care of all that stuff. You also learn what you can completely ignore, which helps a lot with reading it. That's true. I ignore stuff. I mean, I could have ignored that message, but I thought it would be a cool message to answer! This robot is currently in my way! I just took damage for that, too. It's like, really? Took damage again! Sorry, I don't mean to scream. I do mean to scream, though, but... You can't attack this thing with a shotgun, by the way. Doesn't work. Shotgun jump? You do realize that if I shoot this thing with a shotgun, it's gonna bounce back and kill me, right? I've had many alter chances, and... Just see if I can get there from there. Great lava. Great. Lava Mander. And Kali is angry with you.
Yes!
Thanks, Manslave. That's very nice. I hate the volcano so much. I hate it. I really do. Torched! A firebug roasted me alive. One guy got it. Alright, let's try again then. I like how at one point I was able to consistently get to Vlad, now I can't even get there. Maybe it's a mental block, chat. Not the best one, but I get a Matic. A bit of war crimes. Just gonna get a little bit of war crimes, Stan. Mole, please. Mole. 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 Really? Is that what that was? That was the shopkeeper? Oh. No choice. Well, that's a guaranteed Kapala at least. I only have like a couple seconds left, but I'm gonna do this. Fuck it. Okay. Is there the head jet on this? Did anyone see that? If that's the key? Did we see that? Did I get it? I didn't get it. Oh god. I don't think the key is here. Alright, we gotta move. We gotta move! Udjat. Sorry, the Udjat. The Udjat. Bombs. Yang equals no Udjat. Oh, good to know. Thank you. That's good information that I was unaware of. I've been furnished. Shopkeep. No. Hang on a minute. I don't really have time to, because the key is... Where is the key? Fuck. No rope. Can't get back up there. Minute and a half. Maybe with some shotgun jumps and bombs, maybe? Oh no, that's probably not gonna happen now. No. Ah, oh, fuck. I could just bomb my way down, right? Vinny, activate trap. Oh, you're not wrong. No, that's not helping. I think even with a shotgun jump, I might not be able to get up there. I have 40 seconds to find out. Yep, it works. Hang on, there's hope. Is there hope? Though, probably, maybe not. Not my shotgun, that was a shotgun. I can't believe I did that. That's good. A nice run you got there. It would be a shame something were to happen to it. Terrible chill runs up your spine. What?
What do you mean, terrible chill runs up your spine?
It's a nice run you got there. Be a shame if something were to happen to it.
Fucking ghost jar. I will attempt to keep this turkey. Shit, jetpack. Probably don't want that in the volcano. Yeah, the alien blaster too. Well, I saw the arrows going to the right, but not the ones where they were going to the left. And so here we are. That key has been boiled, huh? This won't anger him. Oh. I thought like that was his home. I've wasted many bombs. This run is dangerously stupid. It's gonna get stupider. I'm wasting another bomb. Yeah, and it's not a waste. It's a necessary. It was a necessary thing. But, I didn't want to, like, take the chance. I didn't want to risk. Ooh, that sounded like a lot of explosions. Sorry, turkey. I hate this. I just simply hate this. Take your time. Eat dick. Eat dick, eat dick, eat. All right, okay, here we go. Okay. Yeah. Oh, turkey on 1-1. That's rare. If you don't see lava dripping anymore, you should go down as fast as you can. Why don't you go jungle? I usually do. That's how I was able to actually complete a run. But I'm... For the sake of the death roulette... For the sake of the death roulette, I'm going volcano, and also because practice. I want to practice getting good at the volcano. As you can see, practice has paid off. Look how good I am at the volcano. Ah, yes, two lizards and a mole. Is that the run? Has the run just come to an end? No, not yet. Lots of random crates with bombs in them, at least. You killed my turkey. You son of a bitch! It's worth the health, honestly. It really is. Bets are still open. Are they? Is there any luck in Spelunky or is it all skill? No, it's luck and skill, but... You do the luck, and then the skill follows. You have to make the best of luck, skill, luck. What do you mean? Yang, what do you mean? Yang, what do you mean? Yang, what do you... Yang is dead. The dead turkey was too close. He saw the dead turkey. But that was enough? Fourth turkey appears. That was some cool damage to take right there. Alright, never mind. Nope. Chat, what's going on here? It's not free. That was an accidental pulpage. I did not mean to do that to the turkey. God damn it! The shield is too good. I'm gonna leave the shopkeeper alive. I'm not gonna fuck with that right now. It really is good. Not to crush the key or the pet or everything else that can get crushed.
One thing I would not mind getting crushed. It would give me a rush, in fact. Goku is my Nemu. Popsicle!
It's a piece of shit. Yeah, I had the spike shoes. I mean, I took a calculated risk there, but I'm glad it worked out. Those get crushed too. Jesus. The entire coffin just disappeared. Oh, great. This is very great. horseman's over there. Okay, why? You've missed some really dog shit runs. Oh, there goes the key. Still key. Why did that instantly explode? The shield blew it up.
I see. Well, one must crush. Maximum pain I must endure.
Also, Yaddle has been decanonized. I'd like to let you know, chat. Or so it seems, at least. I bet there are people like, no! That like, are like, what the fuck is a Yaddle? It appears that way. I don't know for sure if Yaddle has been decanonized. Yeah, Yaddle was in episode one, but like in the background. But there was a character that was like, there was only one other, like, this green goblin person. I guess no one's ever really gone. Oh good, yep, you'd be nasty. Shh. Chat, that was Italian. All right, all bets are open. You can bet again. Welcome to real dog shit hours, everybody. George Lucas hated Yaddle. He thought the puppet was haunted. Jeff, did you just make that up? You did, didn't you? You can't pull a fast one on me. The fucking episode one Yoda puppet was haunted. You see how ugly that thing is compared to the original puppet? And then, like, for the DVDs, they redid it. They were like, okay, we're gonna make amends here. We're gonna use CG. And it's like, oh, really? Can't you just get a new puppet? So here's a positive. I'm going to say some nice things about the sequels. Well, I'm going to say a couple nice things about the sequels. One, Yoda puppet looked great in Last Jedi. Two, C-3PO was good in Rise of Skywalkers. Those are my nice things that I will say. God bless and thank you. Someone just said literally shaking right now. The Vader hit sound. Like if it was a Call of Duty and Vader got kicked like an Empire, it would have been
bring my shuttle.
That was a great noise impression. Oh, cool. Yeah, is there a good way to kill Yang? Death. I died by death. Ultimately, this is how everyone dies. Rope would have probably helped. I could have stolen his crossbow. Like I said, this is just real dog shit hours here in Spelunky. Important Yaddle information. Ahsoka never knew about her. Following the Battle of Naboo, Yaddle decided to take a less active role in Jedi affairs, and she stepped down from the council by the time of the Clone Wars. Where'd you get that? Is that Wikipedia? No, I'm not winning today, Hootie. There is no winning. Not a single Olmec encounter, either. And it's like, where's the citation of the Yaddle information? And it's John Lucas. And everyone just assumes that he's like, you know, Lucas's like brother, or like a part of the Lucas LTD. But it's just literally some dude named John Lucas. Very spurious information on that Wikipedia chat. I believe probably a good chunk of it's accurate, but it makes me question them things. Yeah, I mentioned David Prowse having passed away. I thought he passed away. I was confusing him with Peter Mayhew, another very tall humanoid. And it's sad. He apparently, was no longer invited to conventions. I think he threw some shade at Lucas, or, like, something. I don't know who. And they stopped inviting him to Star Wars conventions. I don't remember what happened. Does anyone know? He was pissed at Lucas? Why? What was he pissed about? He spoiled Luke's father? Oh yeah, that was true. He did. Apparently he told people. But I don't know how true that is. So, I say that's true, but that's what I heard. So. Wasn't he mad that... He didn't know about the dub. So he was mad that he didn't get to do the voice for Vader, but... See, here's the thing. I think David Prowse is really, like, great. And he was in A Clockwork Orange, and he was very good in that. So, the problem is, he's from the same town as Stephen Merchant, and his dad actually knew, Stephen Merchant's dad actually knew David Prowse. So here's what they sound like, here's his voice, it's basically like, prepare the ship's coral!
Commander Lothar!
That's not him.
The ship carries the crest of Alderaan.
That is.
Was there any of the royal family on board? Who were you carrying? Intercepted. What have you done with those information tapes?
We intercepted no information. This is a consular ship, didn't you see the markings? We're on a diplomatic mission.
Where are those tapes?
Only the...
Where are those tapes? That's Vader. That's David Prowse doing Vader. So... Yeah, I believe he was from Bristol. So he's got like a very Western England, kind of almost England bumpkin, like a Muswell hillbilly. No, it's good. I mean, I like it. I think it's a cool accent. Was it right for Darth Vader? No, 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 no. James Earl Jones was the best choice. He was so good as Vader. I could not see anyone else in that role. But his physicality was great. Like, any other time someone got in the Vader suit, I didn't buy it. Even Rogue One. Like, it wasn't that it was terrible, it's just something was slightly off. Maybe it was the suit, the height, the fact that David Prowse wasn't in it. I don't know. Especially when they got Hayden Christensen in the suit. That was just... obvious, you know? Turns out, when you're evil, and in the suit, you grow several inches. Also, Hayden Christensen was in one of those straight-to-VOD movies with Bruce Willis. So he's still acting. Alongside Bruce Willis. Bionic legs explains the height. You should submit that to Wikipedia. Oh! Sorry. That frightened me. Thank you, Mole. Dookupedia. No, that's the encyclopedia only for Count Dooku facts. Top 10 Count Dooku facts. Number 1! This is it, chat. This is my final run, by the way, before Hyrule Warriors, so this better be good. It's gonna be good. Dooku was more interesting between Maul and Grievous ignoring EU shit. Yes. No, I agree with that. I just... the movie he was in was just the worst. Fucking hate that movie. But, he had a lot of potential. The worst part about him was his name. They should've just called him Darth Tyrannus the whole time. I get they were doing like a little tribute to Christopher Lee. But, Dooku. I remember my whole high school was making fun of Dooku's name. But no, Christopher Lee was good, even if they had to use CG a lot on his fight scenes. And the backstory was interesting. I wish they would have explored his character a little bit more, though. Like, explain, show, don't tell. Like, what makes his character so morally gray, and why did he leave? What was the point? What's the point of any of this? But, yeah, I mean, let's just say I still prefer Saruman. But I think he did a very good job, given the material. I get the love for the prequels, but I can't watch them without laughing, unintentionally. And I've said that a bunch of times, I'm sorry if you're sick of hearing it by now. There's just so much... there's so much stuff that is unintentionally hilarious. I'm gonna stop talking now because I have to pay attention. Clone Wars explains a lot of prequel stuff. I am aware. I'm just talking about the movies. I understand. I've seen some of the Clone Wars. It is very good. I don't disagree. Just talking about the movies. I need that key. I need those plans! Mine, I guess. Figures it would be here. The one time I don't have the means to kill Vlad is the one time I'm probably gonna get to Vlad. Hoping that shop would be around where I could get the crossbow, but it's not here. Yep, easy. No problem this time. Zero problems getting to Vlad. Yes. But now I have no kill. How do I kill Vlad without all the stuff that you need to kill Vlad? There's a way to do it, right? Telekill? Can you explain the telekill? Have him telefrag himself into a wall. How do you do that? Get close to a wall and whip. Oh, like that. Well, that's good. And I can thank my manslaves for this. They actually did help this time. Truly. They were enough of a distraction that I was able to, just kind of almost do nothing. Do I want to go back up? For the Kapala. No, the manslaves won't come with me. I just have to hope that they're, there's another altar somewhere. Now, here's the thing. Oh, there's an altar. Let's do this first. What's so good about Vlad's cape? Well, you can double jump, and you can slow your fall. Which is really good, and it doesn't catch on fire. Which is another really good feature. And you get double blood. So if you have a Kapala like I just got, I can now eat the blood. And I get more of it. Yo, eat. Gonna go for the exit. I don't want to be the sheriff of Yottingham. I just want to get to Olmec. What is this? Why is he that's Ozymandias. It's a yeah. It's a reference. It's a reference to the art of one of my songs. Hello! Oh! It was just a song, you know? Saved by the skeleton! Oh, yes! Thank you, skeleton. I'll never forget you, thank you. Osteoporobro. Finally. Ooh. All right, well, we got one good run tonight so far. How far will this run go? Let's keep going. Let's keep going. I know a lot of angry chat members right now who Spelunky's death roulette have not been fulfilled by me melting. You can still melt later, don't worry. Yeah, you're not wrong. I'm gonna need some reminders on how to do the secret ending number two. I know I had to fight a turtle man. Like Dana Carvey in the Master of Disguise movie. You need the sword first. You'll have to let me know where that is, because I forgot. No, I mean, like, I know where the sword is, I just don't know where to sacrifice. 4-2? And I sacrifice on 4-3, right? manslave.
Ugh!
I hate them. Did that just ruin the run? No, you're okay. There won't be a bodyguard at the end of, like, all the levels now. Okay, so the sword is here, yeah? If I get the gun, Oh wait, what gun was it? It was a dupe gun, right? Probably already failed. It's easier with the jetpack. Thank you for the blood. Glitched. It's a glitch sword. It's the vine sword from, Bloodstained. Hey, did you know, chat, about that? So then, I drop the cape and the sword on 2-3, right? And then die? In the lava area? A 4-3, not 2-3, what am I saying? You don't have to drop the cape. The cape will come with you. Die after setting off the lava trap. So leave the sword here right now, yeah? Just drop the sword, okay. Okay. Really, dude? Really, dude? Lava cave. Cave entrance. Let me know if you see it, chat. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. So it's in a top left. Bomb to the left side. Is it bottom? Thank you. see it. I do not see it, chat. Time. I think I've dawdled too much. Damn it. Yeah, I see it. There it is. Okay. Chat said that the cape didn't matter. Oh, you got your melted. Why didn't you check first? I was nervous about the ghost. I'm now one of Sakurai's sad souls.
God.
All right, Hyrule Warriors up next. I haven't had a chance to play too much of it, so I want to play it. It's a good Vine Sauce mod. Most of those runs were dog shit, but there was at least one good one. Okay. Everybody, thank you for watching Spelunky. That was a shame. At least you got melted. At least you got your melted. Stick around for a little bit, and then I'll be right back with the Hyrule Warriors. Age of Clamato Juice. Debate about Yaddle amongst yourselves.